Good morning everyone. Now in this video we are going to start learning about the next concept, which is called as the two-factor model. Two-factor model. Friends, before we learn this, we have to learn a concept. I'll just put it as this. The first subconcept should be called as short selling. After we learn that, we will learn how to find out weighted average beta while we do short selling or borrowing. Only once we learn this, I will be able to explain to you what is the meaning of the word two-factor model. So shall we do these concepts one by one now? Let us take the first one. The first subconcept is what? Short selling. Okay. Friends, short selling means we sell first and then we buy later. I hope you are clear with this part. Maybe I'll show you with the help of an example. Suppose there are two people. Okay. I'll call the first guy. Or wait, let me just go back. Sell first, buy later. This can happen in two markets. One, it can happen in the real market or the market which I call it as a spot market, or it can happen in the imaginary market or what is actually called as a derivative market. Friends, derivative market, as I told you, is actually a paper market. So when it is a paper market, you have to only click. Your actual delivery doesn't take place over there. So there you can sell first, buy later, no problem at all. But in real market, is it possible for you to sell a share first without even owning a share and then buying it back? That is not really practical, but it is practical using a very simple technique, which I will share with you now. Let us take two people. First one is, let us say, Anand. And the second guy is, let us call him as Sagar. Okay. Anand is holding a share. He has already bought one share of Reliance for a price of, let us say, 100 rupees. All right. Sagar has not bought any share. Anand is very optimistic. Anand feels that the price will go up, whereas Sagar feels that the price is going to fall down. Now both start arguing. That is when they come to a consensus. The consensus, what they come is that Sagar will tell, do one thing. I will borrow this share from you. Okay, and I will sell this share at 100 with a promise that after 1 year, I will give you this share back at whatever price it is available in the market. So now he has sold this share at what price? 100 rupees. At the end of 1 year, there can be two situations. Okay, so I will call this one as situation number one. In situation number one, he is selling at 100 rupees. At the end of 1 year, let us say the price falls down to 90 rupees. At this time, what Sagar will do is, he will buy back the share. What is the profit that he will make over here? 10. And after doing this, he will hand over the share back to Anand. Now, Anand was holding the share originally at what price? 100. He borrowed from him, sold it, bought it back, made a clean profit of 10 rupees and gave it back to Anand. But at this point, the price is how much? 90. So Anand's point of view, the share that he bought for 100 today is pricing only how much? 90. So what is the loss that he's making over here? 10. Okay. This is an example of short selling, where Sagar is, even though not the owner of the share, he sells the share and then purchases it back and gives it back to Anand. I can give you now situation number two. Situation number two is where the price after 1 year becomes 110. Okay. Now there are two people. The first one is Anand. And who's the second one? Sagar. He is holding one share of Reliance at what price? 100. Sagar is not owning any share. Sagar believes that the price is going to go up. So what Sagar will do is, he will borrow the share. He will borrow the share from whom? Anand. And then he will sell it outside at what price, can you tell me? He will sell it outside at 100 rupees. At the end of 1 year, when the price becomes 110, he will buy it back. Now tell me, and after buying back, he will give it back to whom? Anand. All right. Now tell me, what is the loss that he has made over here? 10. Whereas Anand, he was holding the share, he is making a profit of how much? 10 rupees. This scenario where Sagar is selling the share first and after that buying it back is what we call it as short selling. So basically Sagar gets an advantage. He gets his money in his hands today itself. It becomes an inflow for him. Can you please write down these two things in your books now? Please write down this first. Okay, now please write down this. Alright, so we have learned the concept of short selling. Shall we now go to the next concept, friends? After we learn about short selling, then I told you to learn about weighted average beta. Friends, we have already learned the concept of weighted average beta. We know beta overall is nothing but beta of equity into weight of equity plus beta of debt into weight of debt. I hope you are clear with this concept, friends. Now, I have also told you that there are beta is nothing but it is an indicator of, it is an indicator of what? Non-diversifiable risk. It is an indicator of non-diversifiable risk. Beta XM is one example of non-diversifiable risk, which means for every 1% change in the market, what is the change happening in the security? Beta XI is an example of another non-diversifiable risk. Am I right? For every 1% change in inflation, what is the change happening in security? Now I'll give you an example. Okay, I'll draw a table. Particulars X, Y. Let us say the amount what I invest in both the securities is 100 lakhs, 100 lakhs. What is my total money? 200 lakhs. I will call this as own money. When you look at the weights, can I say it is 50% weight for the first one and 50% weight for the second one? Now, suppose we have got beta XM also and we have got beta XI also. Let us say beta XM is, let us say 2, 4. This is, let us say 3 and 6. Now we need to find out the overall beta. Friends, in order to find out the overall beta now, I can do it separately for beta XM and I can do it separately for beta XI. Shall we do it together now? Okay, so beta XM into weight, I will get the answer as 1, 2. Do I get the answer as 3? Beta XI into weight, I will get the answer as 3 into 50% is 1.5, 6 into 50% is 3. So I'll get the answer as how much over here? 4.5. Friends, here I found out the overall beta, not using only one methodology, but I found it using two methodology. I hope you are all clear with this part also, friends. Now I will go to the next example. I will call this as example number 1. Now I will go to example number 2. Okay. Example number 2, I will draw a table. Particulars. X is there, Y is there. As far as the amount is concerned, I will be putting 200 and let us say I'm putting 300 rupees in, or maybe not, let me not take this much. Let me keep my own money as 100 rupees. Own money. Suppose I'm buying X for 150, but my own money is only how much? 100. So what I will do a short selling of 50 for Y. Everybody clear with this? Now, in this case, my overall weight should be how much percentage? 100%. Here it will be 150% and here it will turn out to be how much? minus 50%. Are you all clear with this part now? Now, I'll put the same numbers for beta xm. I think it was 2, 4. And beta xi is how much? 3, 6. So here also I can find out beta xm into weight. And I can find out beta xi into weight. Alright. 2 into 150% will give you 3. 4 into minus 50% will give you minus 2. So I get the answer as how much? 1. And the other one I get the number as 4.5. And the other one is minus 2. So my overall beta turns out to be 2.5. Now friends, in example 1, I had positive investment in x, positive investment in y. Whereas in example 2, I had positive investment in x, but negative investment in y. I hope you are clear with this part also, friends. I will now go to example number 3. Particulars, x, y, and I will put something called as borrow. My own money, I will assume it to be kept at how much? 100. Example 1, my own money was 200. Example 2 and 3, I'm assuming my own money is only 100. Now what I'm doing is, I buy 300 rupees of x. I do short selling of 100 rupees of y. And the shortfall of 100 rupees, which was coming, I borrowed from bank. So if this is the amount that I have invested, my weights will turn out to be how much over here? 300% minus 100% minus 100. My overall turns out to be how much? 100%. Beta xm, how much I told you? 2, 4. Borrowing is basically risk-free. So the beta of debt or beta of borrowing will turn out to be 0. Similarly, beta xi, I told 3, 6, 0. Now again, I can find out the weighted average beta. Beta xm into weight will be 2 into 300%, that is 6, minus 4, 0. I will get the answer as 2. Here it will be beta xi into weight, that is 9, minus 4, 0. I get the answer as 5. So friends, I hope you are clear with this. Now friends, this scenario where I find out the weighted average using, this is one factor. This is another factor. So this is one factor. This is also one factor. So once I do it using two factors, such a model is what we call it as the two-factor model. I hope you are clear with this part, friends. All right. If you are clear with this part, then we go to the next part and we'll start cracking a problem. I'll give you a minute. Can you please read through this question and understand this question? After which we will do it together. All right, friends, here also there are two securities, security A, security B. We are having factor 1 sensitivity and we are having factor 2 sensitivity. Am I right? They have given the betas, they have given the expected returns also. It is assumed that security returns are generated using what model? Two factor model. All right. So in this case, let us do it together. If Mr. A has invested 1 lakh and sells short 50,000 of security B and purchases 1,50,000 of security A, what is the sensitivity of Mr. X portfolio to the two factors? All right, I'll write down over here now. Working note number 1, he wants to find out the overall beta. Friends, sensitivity of the security to the market is what we call it as beta. So here I want to find out what is the overall beta. All right, so I'll draw a table, particulars, security A, security B, total own money. What is the amount invested in A that they are mentioning over there? 1,50,000 minus 50,000. Do I get the own money as 1? So the weights what I get over here will be 150% minus 50%. Do I get the answer as 100%? They have given factor 1 and then they have given factor 2. Am I right? Factor 1, it is 0.8 and 1.5. Factor 2 is 0.6, 1.2. Okay, so from this, can I find out, you know, factor 1 overall beta? And I can find out factor 2 overall beta. Tell me, what is 0.6 into 150 percentage? 0.9 minus 0.6. I will get the answer as 0.3. And the other one will be 0.9 minus 0.6. 0.8 into 1. Sorry. This will be 1.2. 1.5 will be minus 0.75. So the answer would turn out to be how much? 0.45. The second one will be 0.9 minus 0.6. That is 0.3. Can you please write down till here in your books now, friends? All right. You can pause and write down. I don't want to waste my time for dictation as it happens in the live classes. You can pause, you can write down, and then I can go to the next one. So I can cover a lot more in less time. All right. Now, once you're done with this, let's go and read the second requirement. Please read through it. Mr. X is now borrowing 1 lakh at a risk-free rate of interest and invests in the same proportion of A above. What is the sensitivity of the portfolio of the two factors? Okay, now tell me, how much is own money of X? 1 lakh. How much is the money that he is borrowing now? Another 1 lakh. So what is the total funds available? 2 lakh. This 2 lakh is invested in the ratio of what? Same proportion as above. Above the proportion was how much? 150% and minus 50%. So this turns out to be how much? 3 lakhs. And this one will turn out to be minus 1 lakh. Can you draw this chart in your books? This will go in A. This one will go in B. So friends, if this is the scenario, the remaining 3 lakh minus 1 lakh is 2 lakhs. That 2 lakhs tallies with this 2 lakh. In that, 1 lakh is going to be borrowing. Can you draw this chart in your books now? Alright. Now, based on this, we will now find out the next working note heading. Overall sensitivity. Particulars. A. B. Borrow, then what do I have over here? Own money. Now tell me, what is the amount that he is investing in A? 3 lakh minus 1 lakh minus 1 lakh. So his own money turns out to be how much? 1 lakh. What is the weights coming over here? 300% minus 100% minus 100%. Okay, factor 1, factor 2. Factor 1, what is the way? 0.8, 1.5. Borrowing will be 0. Factor 2 is 0.6, 1.2, 0. So now I'll find out beta overall factor 1, beta overall factor 2. So what is 0.8 into 300%? 2.4. 1.5 will give you minus 1.5, 0. Do I get the answer as 0.9 over here? And the second one will be 1.8. Minus 1.20. Do I get the answer as 0.6? Can you please write down till here in your books now? Alright, so we are done with the second requirement also. Now we'll go to the final requirement. What is the final requirement coming over here? Everyone tell me. What is the expected return premium of factor 2? So they're asking for return premium. First, let me just explain the concept of return premium. Friends, we have learned the formula for risk premium, which is equal to RM minus RF. Am I right? So, which means, suppose RM is turning out to be 12%. Out of this, RF is turning out to be, let us say, 5%. So, since I'm putting my money in the share market, I am getting this extra 7% and this is what I am getting for taking risk. Understood? Just like this, return premium. Okay, the formula is turning out to be RP minus RF. Or suppose the return of the portfolio is turning out to be 15%. If I put in bank, I will get only 5%. So if I put the money in the portfolio, the extra return over and above what I get in the bank is 10%. So I should buy the security only if I feel that this extra return is worthwhile. I hope you are all clear with this part also, friends. Okay, so now let's find out the return premium. In this question, we have requirement 1, then we have requirement 2. Both the requirements, we will be getting separate return premium because the weights are different. So I will do it for requirement 1 also, requirement 2 also separately. Next working note heading will be return premium. Okay. Particulars, RP, then I'll write down what RF. Okay, I'll give a heading called computation. Then I will write down situation 1. Again, I'll write down computation, and then I will write down situation number 2. All right. In situation number 1, can you tell me what is the weights that is given over here? 15% is the return, and the weights are turning out to be 150 and minus 50. So it will be 15 into 150% plus, what about the second one? 20 into minus 50%. Am I right? So that will be 15 into 150% turns out to be how much, friends? Please check. Let me take my calculator. It's 22.5 minus 10. Fine, that's fine. So I'll get the answer as 12.5%. Whereas in the second case, it will be 15 into 300% plus 20 into minus 100% plus, what is the borrowing rate told in the question? RF is 10%. 10 into minus 100%. So that will be 45 minus 20 is 25, minus 10 will be 15%. Now tell me, how much is the RF that we already know? It is 10%. 10%. So tell me, what is the RP minus RF that I get over here? Do I get the answer as 2.5% for the first one? And do I get the answer as 5% for the second one? Alright, I hope you are clear with this part, friends. With this, we are done with the entire concept of two-factor model. Please view the video, pause and learn it again, because this is a little tricky. Once you repeat it once again, it will be easy for you. Alright, thank you so much, friends.